Welcome to Tesca Technologies Private Limited. I am Ayush Jain. Now I am doing the demo of two-stage RC coupled transistor amplifier. The order code of this equipment is 36146. Now here is the equipment. This is our function generator in order to generate the sine, square or rectangular wave. This is our oscilloscope CRO. This is our decayed box, which is also used in the equipment within the scenario. Now, in order to start with the procedure, the detailed study of this diagram, the circuit diagram of the two-stage RC coupled transistor amplifier is given in the lab manual very clearly. I start up with all the experiments that we need to perform. First of all, the first experiment. The first experiment is the study of the characteristics of the two-stage RC coupled amplifier. For this, what we have to do? These are the leads, CRO leads, connected to the sine wave generator. This is the another CRO lead connected to the oscilloscope, also called as CRO. Switch it on. Now, first of all, we will measure the input. For the first experiment, the input is 1 kilohertz and 20 millivolt peak to peak. So set it to 1 kilohertz and measure the input. For input, connect first the red lead to this and a black lead to this. Connect both these accordingly, red to red and black to black. And set a 1 kHz 20 millivolt peak to peak signal. As you can see, the amplitude is very large. We can adjust it through this amplitude button in the function generator. I have set it to 10 millivolt per division. And as it covers two division, it is 20 millivolt peak to peak. Now, in order to perform the experiment, first, I will give my first input to the eye. And the black lead to the ground. Now to measure the output, I connect a red lead to A and connect it to the next CRO lead to red wire and the black lead to the ground. Switch on the mains and now you can see the amplified output. Now it is 0.1 volt per division and it covers 1, 2, 3, 4 blocks, means 0.4 volt peak to peak. The amplitude is amplified. Now the same can be, this is the first part, first stage. Now the same can be performed by giving the input to B point and by taking the output from the O point. This we can see. Here also the amplitude is amplified. The output is 0.4 volt peak to peak. Now the third part is when we coupled both the stages A and B. So give input here to I, short A and B. Through this we short A and B. And take the output from O. You can see the output is further amplified. I have set it to 1 volt per division and it covers 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 volt. So it is 6 volt peak to peak, the final amplified output of the RC coupled transistor amplifier. Now, the second experiment in our manual. It is to study of the frequency response of the individual as well as the RC couple amplifier. We have to study the frequency response, means at different frequency, what is the output? As you can see, first of all, make the connections, give input to I, and output, take it through A. First, set the input as 1 kilohertz and 100 millivolt peak to peak. Now, to set the input to 100 millivolt peak to peak, I connect the red lead to the red lead and black to black. Set it to around 50 millivolt per division and adjust the amplitude. I have taken two blocks, that is 50 plus 50, 100 millivolt peak to peak. Now, to see the output of this, I connect the output through A. Now, this is the amplified output. Now, first of all, we can take 10 readings. My first reading at 1 kilohertz, I can increase it to around 3.3 kilohertz. The amplitude is approximately same. Now, make it to around 10 kilohertz. The variation in amplitude is very less. We have to take the readings from 1 kilohertz to 100 kilohertz. As I make it to 86 kilohertz, the amplitude tends to decrease. And now as I make it to 100 kilohertz, the amplitude is further decreased. Take the different readings and find the gain, which is output voltage upon input voltage. The input voltage is fixed 100 millivolt peak to peak, and the output voltage you can measure according to this signal. Now next is the second part of this. We give the input through A, through B, and the output is measured through O. You can see, first of all, we have to again set the input to 1 kilohertz and 100 millivolt peak to peak. To set the input, I set it to 1 kilohertz. I set it to approximately 1 kilohertz, and the input I have to set is around 100 millivolt peak to peak. This is my input. Now, to calculate the output, I put this red lead to O point. This is my amplified output. I have to take various readings from 1 kHz to 100 kHz, and you can see the amplitude will vary. Make it to 10 kHz, the amplitude variation is less. As I make it to 100 kHz, the amplitude tends to decrease, and we can calculate the final output. The same step is to be performed for the RC coupled transistor amplifier, in which the input is given to the I port. We short A and B, and then the output is taken from O. Similarly, you can say this is the amplified output, and as you increase the frequency from 1 kHz to 10 kHz to 100 kHz, the output tends to decrease, the amplitude tends to decrease, and you can calculate the actual gain, which is gain equal to V output upon V input. We calculate the gain for different frequencies, we get the different gain. Now, to show the third experiment in our manual. The third experiment is calculate input and output impedance of the individual stages as well as that of RC coupled amplifier. Calculate input impedance. Now to calculate input impedance, first we have to make connections as shown in figure. For this, we use a decay box. You can see here, this is the decay box which contains various resistance over it. Now first of all, I make the connections. I give the input of the function generator to the decay box, the output again to this port, and the final output is measured from A. As first I am doing of the first half part, and we have to set the input as 1 kilohertz 100 millivolt peak to peak, as we have set initially 1 kilohertz, and this I have to set to 100 millivolt peak to peak with zero resistance. Now this is at 100 millivolt peak to peak. Now as I increase our resistance, in order to calculate the input impedance, increase the resistance to such a value that make the output half of the initial output. Now as it is 100 millivolt peak to peak, as I increases my resistance, you can see the amplitude is getting minimized. Approximately at 200 ohm, I am getting the half of my initial output. So this is my input impedance for the first stage. Now, in order to calculate the input impedance for the second stage, the same steps have to be taken. Now the input, instead of here, has to be given to the B port, and the output is taken from O. In the same way, the amplitude will decrease and you can measure the input impedance. Now we will measure the input impedance of the RC coupled amplifier. We'll give the input to the same port here. We will short A and B. First of all, before taking the output, we again have to set it to 1 kHz and 100 millivolt peak to peak. This is around 1 kHz and 100 millivolt peak to peak. Now, to measure the output, this is the amplified output. Now, at this point, the resistance is zero. As I increase my resistance, the output will vary.
initially it is 1, 2, 3, 4 blocks, which is at 0.5 volt per division, and as I increase my resistance, now same as around 200 ohm, the output is tends to half. So this is my input impedance for the RC coupled transistor amplifier. Now how to measure the output impedance? In order to measure the output impedance of my RC coupled transistor amplifier, make the connections as shown in figure 5. The decay box has to be put after the CRO, in parallel with CRO. Now my input will be given through this I port. The same step has to be performed for both the first stage, the second stage and the final. I am showing you the exact final, what we have to perform by coupling the two stage RC coupled transistor amplifier by shorting A and B. This is my CRO output, and I will connect my decay box in parallel with the CRO lead. Now this is my output after connecting my decay box in parallel at the output side. Now in order to measure the output impedance, we will increase the resistance till the output voltage becomes half. Now as we will increase our resistance, the output of the output of the RC coupled amplifier will decrease. Now at what resistance we will get the half of the output without resistance, that resistance will be the output impedance. And for further information, please consult the lab manual.
That's all.